I'm Laura, and I'm here to talk about Are We Represented? Start with a little bit of history, lesson history. So representativeness is at the core of our democracy. It's something that's been around for almost 250 years, and the lifeblood or the heart and lungs of liberty. But we're not doing so well at it. Chris actually mentioned several things about trying to increase diversity and inclusiveness in our larger ecosystem, and this relates a lot to that. Pretty much daily there are headlines about lack of diversity in various parts of the country, but especially in pieces of our elected, or within our elected bodies. Working on this project, one of the most surprising stats to me was in the 100 counties, how many people knew there are 100? A nice even number, 100 counties. North Carolina, and the county commissioners, there are, in the entire 100 counties, at least as of 2016, there were no Hispanic or Asian county commissioners in all of North Carolina. And I know that we're not in the most diverse state, but I thought that was pretty surprising. So, that's the state, but what about where you live? What is your county commissioner, what do they look like? What do your city council members look like? What do your school boards look like? And how well or how maybe poorly does that actually relate to your community at large? If you wanted to look this up right now, you might have to go to your local website or, and then your census data and then various things like that. And you can get back to me in half an hour and let me know how that works out for you. It's really hard. So our solution is to make it a little bit easier. It's to take all of that data and put it in one location so that at one quick shot, one website, you could see how well your county commissioners reflect your community. The ideas we're starting with are starting with basic things like gender, race, and ethnicity, but maybe in the future it could also include things like income, education, whether your business or private sector, public sector employees, things like that. But again, it's just to make it easier to understand in one instance what's going on in Wake County, what's going on in Durham County, what's going on where I live. And all this makes it easier to understand what could be or what isn't. So am I represented? Do I feel represented on our elected officials who are passing policies that are affecting me on a day-to-day? How might that affect other things that are going on in my community and other reports and headlines that I see? And again, why is representativeness important? It's because people, when they feel represented, whether that's on private boards or public boards, they feel more part of the party, you could say. They feel like their interests are being better represented. And there's also data to show that women being on boards, also in public boards, pass more women-friendly policies. You can be sure, or more sure, that those voices are at the table that are making decisions that are affecting different segments of the population. It gets more people involved because they feel like a part of the government, and it makes them feel better about the government. So maybe when they call in to report that their trash hasn't picked up, they're a little less angry. And it's a cycle. So it's not just one election making a board representative in one election. It's making it better all around by having more people aware of who's eligible to vote, helping to make sure more people are registered to vote, having more people actually show up to vote, having more people run for office, and then having more people elected. It's a whole cycle, and being able to impact any part of that with data to know how representative those pieces are is important. This is just some local examples. Recently, there was a Raleigh candidate for city council. She was running, if elected, but she was not elected, she would have been the first woman of color, Raleigh City Council. And this is Durham Public School Board member who, 30% of Durham Public Schools is Latino. When he stepped down from office, he recommended that a Latino person be appointed to his position because there are no Latinos on Durham School Board. And that did not happen, so 30% of the population is not represented on the school board. So our app, our site, can help influence things like this. There are lots of local governments. Nerdy local government fact, there are over 3,000 county governments. There are also 39,000, this is just in the country, 39,000 local government entities. So this could go lots of different places. We're specifically talking about looking at the 100 counties in North Carolina. It could be expanded to the counties across the country, as well as municipalities, school boards. And people who would be interested in this data and subscribing to this data or supporting this data are people trying to understand the correlations between representativeness and local policies, as well as to help influence the representativeness and diversity in the cycle that I just talked about. Thank you. Question cohort is also Code for Durham, but we also had people from Code for Asheville and Code for Greensboro involved, as well as some people from Cary. So that was pretty cool.
The prototype that you showed us, have you tested it on users, and how many people do you have signed up?
So again, we start September 30th. I created a really cool sketch. Our MVP was a sketch on a piece of paper. And I've just shared it with some initial feedback, suggesting mainly to think beyond just having information like gender and race, but also intersectionality. So being able to look at when there's been a woman of color versus white men versus things like that. So, and other ways of breaking down the data. And that's the first sketch that we've done of the visualization, and that's definitely something we've been thinking about, is more engaging ways to demonstrate that data, so that people who may not understand the difference between a primary and a regular election can see this and feel like they need to act.
So, at the end of the day, this data, you know, you talk about the people who should be most interested. Every voter should be interested in the fact that clearly they're not voting if they're not being represented here. 100 counties. No, yeah. That was a very interesting stat. I've never heard of that before. I'm a lifetime North Carolinian. Now, that said, I almost want to say, how do you monetize this? Who cares? Is it the organizations? I mean, every voter should care, but fundamentally, we don't. Yeah, because otherwise we would show up and vote and change that. It's easy enough. You vote, and it changes. 30% vote, it changes. But they don't show up. So how do you actually make that tie to where it's really impactful?
This is great.
Teamwork.
We had a discussion, many, many times about the specific sort of decision, I guess. Our customer, we would love for our customer to be everyone, right? Everyone who's eligible to vote, everyone who wants to know a little bit about the representativeness of their locale. But we also need the ability and funding to sort of like do this project, right? The monetization, or sort of our customer that we really have in mind, would be municipalities and local governments who need this information in sort of like a digestible format to even have like a health indicator, right? You know, to regularly look at this and make sure that they're on track for what their goals are. So special interest groups, voter advocacy, those that are interested in their mission of their nonprofit, so to speak, is to use this data to affect change in those places. They're the ones looking for data sets like this.
So before you run out of time, I want to ask the same question. Where are you getting the data from?
Yeah, that's a great question. There are going to be a lot of data sets for this across the United States.
Just stick to North Carolina for now.
Sure. For North Carolina, the American Community Survey covers a lot of the demographic info that we need. Connecting that to the next level would be eligible voters, which is a lot of the data for those next few levels comes from the North Carolina State Board of Elections. Further than that, we have elected officials, those who ran for office, and those are also available through open data portals, at least in North Carolina so far, for county commissioners and city council. And then the last part of that, I'm glad Tim mentioned it, but the Civic Information API does provide a project based on the data that's being collected from the voter information project, which is the aggregate of all of your local officials covering your jurisdiction.
And you guys are actually using that data right now.
We will use that, yeah. The real-time aspect of that is how the UX works. We'll be working towards like collecting that data and correlating it with the other sets that we have, like voter registration.